Welcome back, y'all, to another one. So, riding along this time, trying to shoot some more footage before I leave on Saturday. And so I'm gonna give you my thoughts on my first bikepacking trip and show you a few more views of this town as well. So that's what we're gonna do. So let's go. Okay guys, so I found a perfect place to talk about if bikepacking might be for you or not. I'm like 50-50 about it. One part of me doesn't like it, especially the slow riding, because at points I was riding so slow I felt like I was walking because of the weight. The weight really slows you down, especially going uphill. But downhill is another story. You gain a lot of speed, which is great. And since I wanted to do my travels in a motorcycle originally, so I'm a little bit biased there. The other negative aspect of bikepacking, it's how uncomfortable it can be. But that might depend on your setup. My setup, I tried to get it as comfortable as possible. Changed the seat to a more comfy version, the handlebars and all the stuff, and it was great. I mean, for at least 20 something miles I was okay, but after that my rear end started hurting, and my neck. This is my first bikepacking trip, so you have to keep that in mind. So the comfort level is something to keep in mind. You might not be comfortable after a while, because my neck was hurting, my head was hurting. The next aspect of bikepacking that I didn't like is it's the slow progress. So I was looking down at the GPS, and let's say it was 20 miles to my destination. Like 30 minutes later, it will say 19 miles to my destination because I was going uphill. So that's kind of discouraging, because you ride and ride and you seem like you never get to your destination. Eventually you do, and that's gonna be like 2 hours later. So 20 miles, depending on your, if you are having a headwind or tailwind or going uphill or downhill, it could be you can do it in as little as maybe 30 minutes. No, I'm sorry, 20 miles, sorry. In as little as an hour maybe. Or it could take you a long time. Yeah, that's something I didn't like, because I felt like I wasn't making any progress. Having said that, however, you learn patience. I'm used to ride cars, so I was like used to get there relatively fast compared to a bike. So you learn a lot of patience, that's for sure. Now, the other thing I didn't like, it's the uncertainty of finding a campsite or campground, or just even a place where you can lay down and sleep. Especially when you have been riding for a long day and you want to take a shower, because you are all sweaty and dirty, and you don't want to lay down and sleep like that. Although you might be so tired that you just lay down and fall asleep right away. So there is some planning to go with that. I think that you have to find a place before the sunset, like now. Look at that sunset, by the way. Because if you don't, then dark comes upon you and you need to find something quick, and sometimes it's not possible. And if you try to book a hotel or a hostel or a campground, they might be booked. So I'm probably forgetting something else, but my original thought was to do all these trips on a motorcycle. The problem with motorcycles and scooters or whatever, it's that you might run into issues sometimes at the borders with when you're going to another country. That could be a problem, especially if you are on a limited time. And so that's something you don't have to worry about with a bike. But on the other hand, you get anywhere fast and there's less planning to do. You just go by this, by the seat of your pants, basically. There's some planning, but not as much as you have to do on a bike. So there is that. That's what I like about the motorcycling aspect. The other problem of that is the cost of fuel and maintenance, and insurance and whatnot. Something you don't have to worry about in a bicycle. However, having said that, what I've noticed is yesterday on my first ride, I was like eating a lot. I felt hungry every 10 miles or so. And so I had to drink and eat a lot. I don't think you will have that problem riding a motorcycle because you're riding faster. First of all, you don't feel as hungry as you will on a bike because you're not exercising, basically. So what you probably spend on food, you might use that money towards gasoline. So it kind of balance things out at the end of the day. I need to do some math, basically to see how much money I will be spending on food versus how much I will spend on food plus gasoline. Considering that I will be using less food, I will be eating less. So on a motorcycle, you will be eating a lot less, I think. An e-bike might do that as well, but I'm not sure. I've only have limited experience on an e-bike. So my first experience is it hasn't been totally positive. But at the same time, I really like the few things that I did enjoy. I really enjoyed. So there is that. Anyways, let's go for a little bit more of a ride. I'll show you a little bit more of this city and wrap it up for today.